Hello and welcome to this presentation about using oci-kvm network and storage commands for Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. For our objectives today, in this video, we will review the syntax for the oci-kvm create and the oci-kvm destroy commands used in other videos, provide the syntax for additional oci-kvm commands, oci-kvm create-pool, oci-kvm create-network, and oci-kvm delete-network, and will demonstrate use of these additional oci-kvm commands and create a kvm guest. This slide was described in another video and provides the syntax for the oci-kvm create command and the oci-kvm destroy command. You specify the kvm domain or guest that you want to create or destroy, along with other configuration options and parameters. This slide provides the syntax for additional oci-kvm commands that are the focus of this video. The oci-kvm create-pool command creates a storage pool for hosting guest virtual disk. Pools can be created on block devices or FSS file systems. The oci-kvm create-network command creates a live virt network that uses an Oracle Cloud Infrastructure VNIC. The created network offers an IP range that is usable by KVM guest, and the oci-kvm delete-network command deletes a livevert network previously created by the create-network command. We'll now begin the demonstration portion of this video. To demonstrate use of these commands, I've created a KVM host from the Oracle Linux KVM image on the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. Creating a KVM host instance from the KVM image is described in another video. First, I'll run the command sudo fdisk-l to show the disk devices. The /dev/sdc device is an unused block device which is available to be used for KVM guest. I'm going to use the sudo oci-kvm create-pool -d/dev/sdc-n/vmstore command to create a storage pool. This command creates a storage pool on the /dev/sdc disk, and the name of the pool is vmstore. The create pool command creates a live virt storage pool on top of a disk, allowing you to use a single disk block to host several virtual guest disks. If I run the command virt pool-list, we see the VM store pool now exists. Now I run the command sudo oci-network-config-s to see the network interfaces. You see two attached VNICs. The VNIC with the address of .47 is the secondary VNIC, and this is the one that is available for KVM guests. I'm going to use the sudo oci-kvm create-network command to create a live virt network. This command creates a bridge network on top of a VNIC, allowing a single VNIC to be shared among many guests. I'm including the -n option with an argument of the .47 IP address. This is the IP address of the secondary VNIC on the KVM host. I'm including the -n option with an argument of KVM. This is the name of the live virt network. I'm including the -b option with an argument of 192.168.200.1. This is the IP address of the bridge to be used to build the virtual network. I'm including the -s option with an argument of 192.168.200.128. This is the first IP address in the virtual network address space. I'm including the -e option with an argument of 192.168.200.245. This is the last IP address in the virtual network address space. And the last option in the command I'm using is the -p option with an argument of 24. This is the network prefix in the virtual network address space. The ipaddr command shows the KVM0 entry with an address of 192.168.200.1. If I run the virt net-list command, you see the KVM network is listed. And then I've prepared the command that we're going to run and stored it into a file, so we'll run this command. You run this as root, so it's sudo, then oci-kvm create, and then the name of the domain or guest. I specify the VM store pool, the KVM virtual network, and a disk size of 8 gigs to be allocated from the pool. After the -v option are all the virt install arguments. I'll just copy this command into a buffer and paste it, then we'll run this command. When the system prop returns, you can run the virt console myguest command to view the guest creation process. You need to complete the installation configuration and press B to begin the installation. After installation has completed, you can start the guest and log in. I'll run the fdisk-l command, and we can see that the boot device is 8 gigs as specified in the oci-kvm create guest command. And next I'll run the ipaddr command, and you'll see that the network interface is on the KVM guest. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to learn more about this subject and others. Look for additional videos on the Oracle Linux KVM image on the Oracle Linux Learning Library, and see the education.oracle.com links for comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. This concludes this presentation. Thank you for watching.